Let's continue with the 6-inch project. You're scrolling through Reddit at midnight, frustrated, wondering if there's anything you can do about your penis size. And then you find it. Jelqing. This ancient technique, thousands of forum posts swearing it works, guys showing supposed gains. It feels like hope. But here's what you need to know. That hope is built on nothing. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, one of the most copied urologists on YouTube, because I'm a clinician with real-life experience, while others only copy what I experience firsthand. Let's start with some good news. The penis is not as fragile as you may think. In fact, when flaccid, it's hard to harm it. But here's something that'll probably surprise you. As soon as the penis starts to erect, you've got to be careful what you do with it. Jelqing is done in the half-erect state. Guys, you're just one step away from disaster. This is how my patients describe it. They jelq and poof, complete shutdown of the penis. Erection's gone. For good. I'll get to the reasons in a minute. But first this. Jelqing has zero scientific evidence. Not a little evidence. Zero. The Sexual Medicine Society of North America looked at this. Major urological associations looked at this. Nothing. No peer-reviewed studies. No mechanism that actually works. Just anecdotal claims from the internet. So let's repeat the theory. You massage your half-erect penis from base to tip. Supposedly, this creates micro-tears in the tissue. Your body heals them bigger, like muscle building. Yeah, but the penis is not a muscle. It's an organ. And yes, there's muscle inside, but a very special type of muscle. It's called smooth muscle. Not the kind you know from the gym. The penis is a complex system of blood vessels and elastic tissue. It is determined by genetics and what pregnant women eat. So if you want your son to become huge, you have to do two things. First, look at the penis size of your brother-in-law. If he's packing, chances are good genetically. The second point is diet. What can your partner eat to maximize that genetic potential? If you don't want to miss out on that, you could subscribe to UroChannel, so you will be notified when I post that video. Anyway, Jelqing causes micro tears, not growth. On the contrary, it triggers scarring. Here's where it gets serious. Case reports from major urology centers document men developing veno-occlusive erectile dysfunction from Jelqing. That's a fancy way of saying the tissue damage breaks your ability to maintain an erection. Some of these guys needed surgery to fix it. I've looked into this and I'm not sure whether this is a problem of veins. Rather, I think it could be related to overstretching or traumatizing penile nerves. That would make more sense given the typical medical history and course. We've documented Peyronie's disease linked to Jelqing. That's penile curvature and fibrosis. We've seen bruising, pain, permanent numbness, tissue damage. These aren't theoretical risks. These are real complications in real patients. Next week, I'll see the next victim. Let me put it this way. It's dangerous advice. Treatment will cost you thousands of dollars, success not guaranteed. So think twice before you engage in this. Now, I get why you think it's a good idea. You see your penis as something you should be able to control, to improve, to fix. There's dignity in that impulse. But Jelqing isn't control. It's harm disguised as action. If you genuinely have a medical issue, Peyronie's disease, post-prostatectomy shortening, actual micropenis, we have real options. Penile traction therapy, actual devices, studied, measured, safe. Men using these gain an average of 1.6 centimeters or roughly an inch with documented safety. But if you're doing this because you think your penis is too small when it's anatomically normal, that's not a penis problem. That's a narrative problem. And the solution isn't Jelqing. It's talking to someone who understands male sexuality and can help you separate internet myth from reality. A therapist, a urologist who gets it. Penis size has a lot to do with genetics. It all comes down to one single person. Your mother. This video gives you the details. Subscribe, share, and like, and be prepared for the upcoming episode about PBD. Oh, you don't know what that is? The penis boosting diet, of course. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, always copied, never matched.